Yam Rim Nimitam Ava Mangalam Chaya Yoja Sambhidiyo vivajjantu sabdaroko vinasatu Mate bhavanvandarayu sukhidhigayuko bhava Bhavatu sambha mangalam rakhantu sabda devata Sambha gundaru bhavena sarasakti bhavantu te Bhavatu sambha mangalam rakhantu sabda devata Sambha dhammanu bhavena sarasakti bhavantu te Bhavatu sambha mangalam rakhantu sabda devata Sambha sanghanu bhavena sarasakti bhavantu te
心。 冷静超然平和的时候，我们处在于一个能够把自己当下的智慧发挥到顶点的状态。当你能够把自己的智慧发挥到顶点，那已经是最好的。如果说还有什么错误，那也是生命里面必然要经过的学习过程，那就没有什么遗憾。但至少我们允许自己把自己的能力发挥到最好，自己的智慧发挥到最好，然后把不需要受的苦，不需要犯的错，不需要走的冤枉的路离开。So we talk about how we change our fate. We talk about that actually this thing so-called fate in reason, in the law of nature, it is not something that is fixed. It can be changed.And we change it according to nature law, according to the principle of dependent origination, that things arise because of various conditions. And if we understand the conditions, we know how to change by putting in right conditions. And then we talk about the first step. The first step isLet go of the burden of I, of selfishness, of ego, that corrupt our perception, that corrupt our vision. Because of ego, because of the wrong notion of I, and because of my cover of my defilements, we are not able to see things as they really are.We are not able to experience lives purely. And when that happens, we always come to wrong judgment, wrong perception. So, we also talk about why we shouldn't trust ourselves when we are not emotionally balanced, when our feelingsare disturbed, not having good feelings. At that time, you need to be detached and wait until everything gets to smooth natural state. So when feelings are no good, do not trust our perception, do not trust ourselves, do not trust our judgment.Because we cannot exercise pure wisdom when we are emotionally affected. Even though we say we can think rightly, but actually not. So we must give our wisdom a chance to operate. So when we are detached, calm, free from selfishness, then our mind, our wisdom, our present wisdom can function to its highest efficacy. That is the best we can do for ourselves. What more can we do? If even that, even by doing that, if we still make mistakes, well, those mistakes are meant to be learned as in a process of learning in life.We cannot blame, that's the best we can do already. If we invoke the highest wisdom, our present wisdom, then there will be no regret. Even if we make mistake, there will be no regret. At least we work out our wisdom to the best we can. And then, when our perception is pure, we are able to find a answers how we can transform our life. And we also say that it is impossible if you want to change our life against nature law. You have to do it according to nature law, universal laws. The laws that exist in this universe, whether the Buddha declared or not, just like gravity exists in this universe, whether Isaac Newton declared or not. So, if we want to change our life, we need to change it in accordance to nature law. So some people, when they change their life, they work very hard, but come to no effect. They try to make them lead a happy life, but because of not understanding what is the nature of law, they are adding causes of suffering. And when they add causes of suffering, no matter how hard they work, they only end up suffering more and more. But if for those who know nature of law, they work accordingly, then they will be able to change their life successfully. Eventually, all this effort will bear fruit. So, we also thought that we need to change our life, we need to follow the nature of nature. You cannot violate the nature of nature to change your life. for us to effectively go on to the next step. 所以第一步很重要，第一步做得好。就能够有效地让我们迈向下一步。第一步看起来好像一种被动的，你不需要做太多东西，其实是平静放下，让自己的心里的什么杂质自然的沉淀，回到原来的状态，沉浸的状态，清静清理的状态，那么让我们能够很如实、很清楚地看到生命的真相，知道应该做什么，下一步该做什么，要想也想得清楚，要关照也关照得清楚。然后接下来你就不但有了第一步，有了巩固的第一步，接下来你就可以采取比较正面、积极的一步。去改造生命，这个明明是可以改造的。在《无上的经经》里面有一个故事，给我很大的，曾经给过我很大的启发。当然，它是一个故事。这个是不在在不同时代的故事，所以也许你在这个时代，以现在这个时代的智慧，也许你未必会更能够接受那个故事的情节，因为它牵涉到什么天神啊之类的。有些人不相信有天神，没关系。如果你不相信有天神，你可以以这个故事当作寓言故事来学习。如果你相信，也就可以。那么这个是朱拉嘎林的加达嘎，这个摩萨本圣经第301个故事。那这时呢，就想到古时候和上古时候有两个国王，两个国家，两个国王，一个是嘎林嘎国和嘎林嘎国王，一个是阿萨嘎国和阿萨嘎国王。那么这个嘎林嘎国王呢，嘎林嘎王，他有十个很漂亮的公主。那么这个嘎林嘎王很会打仗，古时候的打仗都是国王带头，国王做国王都是要最会打的。所以呢，他有这十个漂亮的公主，他就想，那时他打遍了天下无敌，他觉得好像有人来跟他打仗，他就有点不过瘾。他想，谁没有人敢跟他打的？他太会打了。他就想，哪里我可以找到我的对手呢？那这时呢，那么他的官员呢，大臣就跟他讲：“国王很容易的，你用那个车，把你的四个女儿载着放出去，看有哪一个国王会为了要得到你的女儿。”给你的女儿吸引，会跟你宣战，有吸引力就会有勇者出现，到时你就会有对手，就会有人跟你打，很奇怪呢。然后于是这个嘎林嘎王他就接受这个指示，这个建议，然后就把他的公主们扮得漂漂亮亮的就去，然后走到每一个国家，人们都快快地把城门关起来。为什么呢？不要让你的公主挂进来，进到来的话我借她一起呢，要了这个公主，那就是要跟你打仗。哎呀，有这种话，这个嘎林嘎王太厉害。结果呢，就是一直走，一直走，走偏了一步，一直都没有。很多国家呢都不敢那个。可是绕了一个圈子回来的时候，就回到他的邻国，因为他从一边出发，从另一边回来，到了他的邻国这个阿萨嘎这个地方的时候呢，这个阿萨嘎王也说：“哎，把城门关掉，不要让他的公主进来。”哎，我不敢跟这个国王打仗。可这时这个阿萨嘎这个王呢，他有一个大臣， 智慧的大臣降临，叫做南帝仙呢。这个南帝仙呢，他很聪明，他想，如果我们让这个四个公主就像离开回到他的国家，那真的是我们这个印度也不称不上是印度人，那是实在是大家好像是好像整个印度都没有人才这样不行啊、嗯！他去劝他的国王想，没关系，不要担心，我们会打赢他的、嗯、所以、就把他的国王这个公主请进城里，进了皇宫，然后让他立他们为皇后，那当然这些大事直接把这个公主接回来立为这个阿萨嘎的国王的皇后呢，当然就是准备说这个阿萨嘎国王要打仗、要接战了，所以、就这样，然后卡林嘎国王然后就给他们给卡林嘎国王发了一封信去准备交战。So I will tell a story whichAt one time, the message in this story inspired me quite a lot. But the story, whether you want to, it comes from the Jataka story, the stories from the Buddha's previous birth. Some people may not like to believe it because it involves devas and stories about devas and things like that. Some people do believe that about the existence of devas, but it doesn't matter.If you, because this story takes place in a long, long time, it's a different world. In a different world, it's very difficult to believe the context, the environment, the culture, everything are different. So, just like people in 30 years ago, it's very difficult to imagine the world 30 years later as we are having now. 30 years ago, you didn't have internet, you didn't have handphone.And people's life and communication are very different. But now it's very different. So you see,、so similarly, it's very difficult for now, for our people at present time, to imagine、an ancient world. Sometimes people's life can go up to few, human life can go up to thousands, like 8,000, no, 10,000 years old. It's very difficult to imagine that type of world.When people's lifespan was very long. Of course, people nowadays find it very difficult to believe. But put aside this. One day, if you meditate more, you may understand more about this. So, coming back to our story, it doesn't matter if you find the story, the contents difficult to believe, you can also take it as a favor and learn the message from it.I think the message is more important than whether the story is how real the story is. It doesn't matter. More important is the message. So we come back to the story. There was one time in the ancient time, there was this Kalinga kingdom and this Asaka kingdom. And the king is called Kalinga king and Asaka king. And this Kalinga king,He has four very beautiful daughters, princesses. And he is a very powerful king. Very good on the battlefield. Very strong to fight. Those days, kings, when they fight, the king is always the leader in the fighting. Unlike today, the king will send people to fight, and they will hide behind. But those days are not like that. King always goes to the forefront and fight.So this king, he was so good in fighting, he couldn't find a rival. Nobody dared to fight with him. He's so famous for his power, his mighty power. So he got bored. No rival, very boring. Life so boring for a person who likes to fight. So he started to voice out, how can he find a rival? And then one of his ministers gave him this suggestion.Very easy. You just put your four daughters, four princes, on the carriage and let them travel all around. India and tell them, whoever like to marry these four daughters must fight with the father's will, fight with the king. So with this temptation, this attraction, they will always come up with people who are brave to fight. So, okay, so the king accepted his suggestion and sent the daughters abroad and to other countries. But in the countries, when they heard these are the daughters from the King Kalinga, and to marry these daughters, you have to fight with the king. Everyone's scared. It's not worth it. Even though the big daughters are very beautiful, but if you marry the daughters, you have to fight with the king. So, a powerful and mighty king. So, nobody there. So, all close their fortune without not allowing these daughters to come into their country. Better don't meet them, others get in trouble. So, when these four daughters travel all around India, they go from one direction and come back in another direction. They came back in another direction. So, no countryman, no kings dare to accept them to marry these four daughters until they came back to their neighbor. Another side, they came back to their neighbor, which is this Asaka country. So then, even this Asaka king also gave the order, closed door, don't accept this, you don't want to fight with Kalinga. But this king Asaka, he has a very wise minister. His name is Nandisena. This Nandisena was thinking, well, the India will be called empty. When if nobody dares to take up this challenge, India becomes empty. It's empty. No warrior, no great warrior comes up. It shouldn't be like that. So he was thinking, okay, now. They told the king, no problem, don't worry about it. We'll find a way to win this battle, this Kalinga. But, so please accept these four daughters, four princesses. So, okay. So the king also followed the advice of this minister and taking these four princesses, we can make them queens of Asaka king. So he sent a message to Kalinga and said, now we have our king has married your daughters, so we will accept a challenge. But please do not come over to our country. We will fight at the border. So two armies to fight at the border. So King also accepted that advice. So if they just want to fight, it's not to conquer the land, but they just have the desire to fight, just to prove their mighty power. So they came to the border. So before they start the fight, this Kalinga king, he was thinking, there are ascetics around. And these ascetics, they have great powers. They have a power to prophesy things, what will happen, what will turn out in the future. So better I go to an ascetic and search and ask, who will win this battle? So at that time, our Bodhisattva was actually an ascetic at the border of both countries. So this Kalinga king came to this Bodhisattva, this ascetic, and asked. So he didn't disguise not as a king, he disguised as an ordinary people, he had asked, when these two kings fight, who will win? Asked the Bodhisattva, the ascetic, the hermit. And then the hermit said, well, one side will win and another side will lose. So, but anyway, this is just general answer. Always someone will win and someone will lose. Someone will be defeated. Anyway, if you want to know the exact answer, with tonight, Saka. Saka is a Deva king. Saka is coming to me. So I will ask Saka, who will win? So come back in a few days' time, and I will answer you. I'll come back tomorrow, I will answer you. 那么这个呢，当那个这时他们准备要打仗的时候呢，这个卡林盖王呢，他们就想准备他们两方面呢，这个阿萨卡这个男子，那他们就送个讯息给了卡林盖王，说好，我们接受你的挑战，就让我们国王娶了你的女儿做你的公主，做这个王后。那么现在呢，你要战可以，可是不要在这里的国土上战，我们在边界上战。好，然后他们就准备了来到边界。这时呢，这个卡林盖王他去想，这些到处呢都有些修行人，这修行人这个很大的能力，他们能够知道预测未来。所以倒不如我先还没打仗之前，先去问一下谁会打赢。结果呢，他就一次呢，他就装成一个平凡的人，来到这个边界来找到一个修行人。而这个修行人就是我们的菩萨，释迦牟尼佛的亲师菩萨。那这个菩萨呢，他就问他，当时他做一个装扮的一个凡夫，平凡的人就问他，现在有两个国家都要打仗了，两个国王要打仗。请问呢，你谁会赢？那这个菩萨就说：“哎呀，有一方会赢，有一方会输了。当然是如此。不过如果你要知道准确的答案的话呢，那明天你倒回来，因为今晚呢，天上的天空呢，闭塞，33天的天王会下来找我。那么我呢，我问他，请天王呢，萨迦呢？”问一下他到底哪一个国王大战必赢，我再告诉你。那么那天晚上呢，提空就来了，然后这个武山就问他到底在打仗呢，谁会赢，而且会有什么迹象。那么提空就想，噶林盖王会赢，阿萨卡王会输，而且他也把那个打仗的时候呢所出现的迹象预测说了出来。于是呢，这个噶林盖王来的时候呢，他去跟他，就来问的时候呢，他就回答说：“那你会赢，因为那个噶林盖王会赢。”但是呢，噶林盖王没有问，他没有问你会怎么赢，他并没有问会有什么现象，他也没有问。他一想到我会赢，他就很高兴的就离开了，So the nine Saka came, and then told this Bodhisattva, when Bodhisattva asked the question about who will win the battle, Saka answered Kalinga King. King Kalinga would win the battle, and King Asaka would be defeated. And then he also explained that at that time there would be such moments and such sign would happen, something that is this.Whatever will happen during the battle, King Saka mentioned. King Saka is the Deva king, the king in Tavadinsa, the king of Deva. So he has a psychic power, he could predict and to prophesy who would be. And he would know what would happen. So when King Kalinga came, he inquired who would be.He was told that King Kalinga would win. He was very happy. He thought, I would win the battle. But he didn't inquire what would happen during the battle. He didn't inquire. So he was so happy, he went back and spread around the news saying that the ascetic told him that he would win the battle. So the news spread around. Before the battle, everybody the news spread around. So the army of King Kalinga was so happy.They thought definitely they would win the battle, so they were so happy. So, overjoyed. So when this report came to Asaka's side, this Asaka summoned Nandisena and said about his worry that he would lose the battle. Nandisena said, don't worry, we'll find a way to overcome this. So he also went to the Bodhisattva and asked. And the Bodhisattva told him exactly,King Kalinga would win. But this Nandisena was smart. He asked for the Bodhisattva about the omen, what would happen during the battle. Then the Bodhisattva told this Nandisena. At that time, there will be a daiti, a deva, means kind of, actually there are many types of kind, something like kind of very low type of deva. They usually sometimes when kings, sometimes they may have people with extremely strong karma, they have their deity and that support them. They have due to some karmic link. We don't go into deep into this aspect. So this the war deity for this the conqueror will be a spotless white bull. It appears in the form, it manifests in the form of spotless white bull, which is cannot be seen by ordinary eyes. But the loser, the deity of the loser, would be a perfectly black bull. And then these two bulls, these two deva and the devana, the deity fight with each other. When the war was going on, actually this the deity of the king also they would fight with each other. So it was very bad.
Immediately, these 90s stop them. Stop, stop. Don't do something like this.
This is not the way to sacrifice for our king. Tomorrow, when the war comes, give your best. Put in the best fight. Okay. Then, in this way, he puts up the spirit, the morale of these warriors. So these Kalinga's army, the king was already here. So not everything is they're having a good time. They were no worry that they were going to lose it because they were very confident that they will win the battle. So when they actually come to the battle, they were not well prepared. In fact, they were strong. So they couldn't give it a good fight. This is one thing. And also during the fight, this man is going to ask the king, ask his king, ask Saka, can you see the war deity of both sides? Anything, something like a white moon and then the dark black moon? Say, yes, I can see. Because only the kings could see, other people couldn't see. It's very strange somehow. So he says, okay, now you're right here. You get down from your horse and move forward and take a spear. The spear at the war here of the opposite side of the white, that one which manifests in the white, in the form of white moon, and attack it. And once you attack it, and then the rest of us, all of us will shoot out, shoot in the spear in this way. And then the king took this suggestion and went forward and actually killed the war deity. And then when that happened, and also when the warriors were so brave, they fight across, and then eventually they put all the whole Kalinga king's army to flight. So they won the battle, as King Asaka won the battle. So in this 真正的这个时候呢，这个卡里巴王呢，军队呢，他就想我一定会赢的，所以呢，你就没有真正的下心思，真正准备，所以等到真正要用他们的力量的时候呢，他们也放松了，没有真正的打，所以这是第一个失败的原因。第二呢，就是在真正打的时候，国王跟国王接近的时候呢，那么这个南迪贤呢，就问他的卡萨卡王。 里面有什么战神之类的东西，他就用对方的是显现成一个白牛，我的是显现一个黑牛，在我这方面的。那么他想，好，你先下马，拿起你的剑，拿起你那个标枪，标这个对方的战神，把它标死。你一标，我们有个标，一起把它标死。结果他们就一行动呢，就把对方的战神那个白牛的。
就标死了，然后这时呢，但一千个战士又那么勇猛的站过去呢，所以你很快的这个便就倒了，这感应到王就跑了，好的，所以他们这个阿萨嘎王就战胜了。所以当他战胜的时候呢，这时呢，这个感应到王在逃走的时候呢，他又来找这个。 菩萨，他骂他，你怎么能够撒谎呢？修行人怎么能够撒谎呢？这些撒谎是不可以的。你讲我赢，结果我输了，这样很生气，他就骂了这个菩萨一顿，菩萨就杀杀的给他骂了一顿。那么过几天，这个天上的沙甘又来了，提神又来找这个菩萨，这菩萨也就跟他说。 你为什么骗我呢？你骗我天神是不撒谎的，天神是不撒谎的，为什么你会撒谎呢？这时呢，这个天王呢，萨迦，他就想，啊，婆罗门呢，他向这个菩萨婆罗门饶命，你难道没有听说过吗？连天神呢，都羡慕啊，都妒忌一个勇猛的英雄，一个有。
定下心的有很大决心的绝不放弃的战士的勇猛英雄，能够有很多善于善用自己的聪明去战斗，有很高的勇气，而且有很大的那种冒险的力量的等四种力量的。那么所以呢，因为这四种力量有很坚定的决心，有很大的那个智慧呢，懂得用智慧呢，有很大的勇气，而且有很强大的冒险的力量，那么所以呢，这个沙嘎呢就赢得了这场战役。So when King Kalika he lost the battle, when he lost the battle, and he was fleeing, running away, he approached the ascetic, the Bodhisattva. He reproached his calling. Why how can you lie? Ascetic never lie.Recruits never lie. Why you lie to me? You told me I would win the battle, but actually I lost it. I was defeated. It's no good. You are not a good ascetic. So after scolding our Bodhisattva, he went back to his country. Then a few days later, the Sakha came to this hermit, came to our Bodhisattva, and then the Bodhisattva also asked the King Sakha,Why you lie? They was never lie. Why you lie to me? Because of your lie, I got scolded. Then King Sakha said, Has thou, O Brahmin, never been told, God can be not the hero bone? The fixed resolve that may not yield, each of the powers in the field, high courage and adventurous might, for Sakha has won the fight. And this is in the first form. Actually,The gods, even the devas, envy the hero, a bold and brave hero. A hero which has a fixed resolve that never yield, never give up. Fixed resolve. Intrepid progress means wisdom. That wisdom of a hero. High courage, brave, an adventurous mind, powerful and strength. Because of that, this Asaka has won the fight.The Buddha at the end of the story said he was a hermit, he was a Bodhisattva, and then Nandisena was actually our later we know to be Sariputta. And the four daughters who at the time are Arahant, the female ascetics. I didn't tell the present life story, but just talk about the previous story. So,this story, at that time when I read, I was not so much interested in what is a war or fire or battle. But it told me something that actually, even if something which is prophesied, a fate predicted by God, it can be changed. That message is beautiful to me. That even if it is God that prophesies you, that prophecy.May not be fixed, it can be changed. Since I read this story, I start to work on. Whenever I read the suttas, the dhammas, whatever, I always work on how can I change fate. That makes it was a big help to me, this story. So whether, to me, the message is most important. It doesn't matter about the details of the story. The message told me that I must find a way.Change fate. 所以呢，这个故事呢，当这个故事结束的时候呢，我都就说他就是那个修行人的那个菩萨。那么那个南尼杰那呢，就是未来的这个舍利弗尊者。那么那四个公主呢，就是后来成了阿罗汉的那个辩才、那个辩论的那个女。修行人后来真的比修行人这样，但是故事呢，讲的是那种决心啊、智慧啊、战斗智慧啊、勇气 还有那个强大的那个力量，那种敢冒险的那种力量。当然这个不是打仗，这个东西不是我所感兴趣的，我感兴趣的是他传达的讯息，就是即使是天神下来，那这么厉害的披风下来，一色做的一色都可以被推翻，我一个人有决心可以改善生命，这个讯息对我来讲非常的珍贵。自从我读了这个故事，我得到这个讯息过后，我一直都在寻找，在读经的时候我一直在寻找改变生命的方法。那么第一步，你要相信生命可以改变，命运可以改变。你不相信，那个不相信本身就成了思想的极限，思想的极限最可怕，人最怕就是没有思想的勇气。你没有了思想的勇气，那么什么都不能。至少我们要找出什么是可能的，当我们知道可能为可能的时候，我们就要有勇气去实践，要敢想，不是妄想。如果是真实的可能的，那么我们要相信，只要我给这个可能的事情注入对的因缘，那么它就会有结果出现。时候到了，因缘具足成熟的时候，就会有结果。这个信仰要有，你没有相信，你不相信，那怎么能够做呢？就像一个雕刻家，如果他看见一块石头，他想象不出一个天使的模样，你想他怎么能够雕刻出一个天使的模样呢？所以心里面的影子很重要，相信可能它才可能。但是这个相信也要符合自然界的规则，你不符合自然界的规则也不可能。所以但至少要排除思想的极限，你第一件事情你要相信命运可以改造。So the message of that our life, our faith can be changed is such a powerful message. The believing is very important. If we believe our faith cannot be changed, whatever is told to us by fortune teller cannot be changed, then it becomes a limitation of thought. It limits our thought, limits our power of thinking. We will have no courage to think. In fact, the courage to think is very important courage. If you don't even have the courage to think, how can we make it possible, even if it is actually possible? So this is one thing very important that we must believe that it can be changed. So in this story, it tells us about resolution, wisdom, courage, and adjustment is actual power. And this is for the war. But in other aspects, if we apply the mind, it actually comes from mind power. We are not teaching about how to fight, but we are teaching how to have strong mind power to live a life. And if you want to apply in meditation, then also we can apply in a modified way. Meditation also requires determination, wisdom, courage. Without courage, also very difficult. Every now and then, get disappointed, get disheartened, also very difficult. And then we must actually have mind power. So this will help. Whether we want to change our spiritual life, our daily life, our worldly life, we need mind power. This I will proceed to discuss more in the coming talks. How to invoke the power of mind in changing our fate. The various powers of mind. 所以这个故事呢，在故事里告诉我们四种力量，一是决心，二是智慧， 三是勇气，吃是力量。那么这个力量就看各种看你用在各个层面怎么说，这不是你的，它是讲战争。基本上要讲的就是心的力量。生活上我们不要讲战争，生活上你要有强大心力，你才能够把生活上的问题克服。那么如果是禅修也一样，禅修你要修禅，你需要有这个学习，没有学习的人三心两意两下子就放弃，怎么会成功？要有智慧，要用对方法，然后要有这个勇气，没有勇气两下子一点遇到点挫折去沮丧的修行也不会成就。两下子只剩对心，他怎么能够修行呢？灭苦这种肉身怎么这样大的成果，涅槃这样好的，这样大的成功成就，怎么是小小的力量、小小的心力等就能够达到的呢？那么接下来就是那个力量，种种的力量。所以我们讲到呢，其实没有了排除的思想的集训过后，我们要培育我们的心力。心力是心的力量，能够帮到我们改造我们的身体。这就是为什么我们来学佛，我们要修这样定慧，除了戒，要戒定慧，戒掌控自己的能力。然后定培养定力，然后智慧，这些都是心的力量，往后我们再慢慢的讲解。所以要懂得，如果要改变生命，你要懂，那有了心的力量，你还要懂得自然界的法则。你要懂怎样善用自然界的法则，怎样善用法的力量，心的力量，法的力量，还有业的力量，怎么用？这个我们要从佛陀的法里面寻找答案。那讲回来，刚才我们讲到，把善用自己当下的智慧的顶点，但如果我们智慧不足怎么办？我们让更高的智慧引导我们。要用佛陀的智慧，最好的智慧，最好用的智慧就是佛陀的智慧。那么如果我们对佛陀的智慧又不容易掌握，读经又不能够明白的话呢，那我们怎么办？那我们就要找出有智慧的老师，让有智慧的老师引导我们去吸收佛陀的智慧。那么即使是我们的智慧没有那么高，但借着佛陀的智慧，我们也能够让更高的智慧、更高的法在我们生命里运作，这个很重要。智慧叫什么？清净而烂，清净而废。We need to know the power of mind, strong power of mind. We also need to know, we have to go along with nature law, to invoke the power of Dhamma.Then we also need to invoke power karma. So these are very vast subjects, cover a lot of aspects, scientifically, morally, a lot of aspects. So it takes some time to slowly to explain. We can go on into many, many talks. But one thing useful, just now we talk about invoking our present wisdom to the best of our ability, to the best of our present wisdom. But in this aspect, I have something to say. If, what happens if our wisdom is not sufficient, then we try to use higher wisdom.Allow higher wisdom to help us. let the Buddhist wisdom guide us. We let the Buddhist wisdom guide us. But what happens if we find it difficult to understand the Buddhist wisdom? When we read the text, we find it difficult to understand. And when that happens, we have to use our best, our present wisdom, to seek out wise men. That will have better grasp, better understanding of the Buddha's wisdom, the Buddha's teaching. So, through the teaching, explanation of wise men, we are able to come closer and closer to the Buddha's teaching. With that, we can, even though if our wisdom are not sufficient, but if we allow higher wisdom to guide us, then we are able to live according to higher wisdom. That is one of the effective tools to change our fate. To live along to get the help of higher wisdom. That's why in the text, the one time when Venerable Ananda told the Buddha, I think wise Karyanamita, wise friend, good friend, is half of our spiritual life. Then the Buddha said, no, do not say that. Wise friend, Karyanamita, good friend, is the whole of spiritual life, not half, whole of spiritual life. See how important it is, because with the guidance of wise friend, the wise people will teach us how to live in accordance to truth, to Dhamma, to natural laws. And when we are able to invoke the power of natural law, for the power of truth in our life, then that's the most powerful thing. Because Dhamma is the most powerful thing in this universe. If only we know how to appreciate that. If only we know how to use that. So this will come in future talks. So, this is very 特别在改造生命方面是非常重要的。是李维斯在经典里安南尊者跟佛陀说，佛陀说，我认为善有伽耶那密达善有是心行生命、梵行生命的一半。佛陀说，别这么说，安南，别这么说。 善有是泛行生命里的全部，不是一半，是全部。你想佛陀给这么大的强调，对善有这么大的强调，你知道那是多么重要吗？为什么？因为通过善有的引导，我们能够依自然界的法则而活，我们能够在生命里面发挥出法。 的力量，要知道法的力量实在是世间最强大的力量，只是人们一般都不知道怎么用。如果我们懂得用，这个力量是我们生命里面广大强大的力量。所以善有的引导帮到我们，活出了自然界的法则，发挥了法的力量。 这个如何发挥法的力量，这会在接下来的讲座里面跟大家分享。So, it's very important that we believe that we can change our life and we sincerely want to work out our life and live according to nature law. We will have your wisdom. allow ourselves to be guided by a wiser one. So this way, we find an effective and efficient way, a quick way towards changing our life, towards uplifting our life. 所以通过愿意让自己更引导，那我们可以活出更高的智慧来改造自己的生命。但如果要做到这一点呢，我们一定要有谦虚的心，愿意接受引导，才会有这种效果。如果我们没有谦虚的心，我们有傲慢心，那就不能有这种作用。 So, Very important rule in our life. We need to be humble. Otherwise, it will not work. So we need to have a humble mind to receive the guidance of a wiser person, to receive the guidance of a wiser ones, so that we can invoke the power of higher wisdom. So with that, I wish all of you always have better life, better future, and ever move towards the light. 所以我祝福大家，愿你们都能够一而再地提升你们的生命，总是让你的生命走向光明。